Who is Stephen Sondheim? If you've spent any time in musical theater, or theater in general, the name Stephen Sondheim probably rings a bell. Stephen Sondheim is a gifted composer, lyricist, and playwright. He was born March 22, 1930, in New York City. His parents, Herbert and Janet, were divorced when he was young. Sondheim's musical career started when he was only 4 years old, studying piano and organ. Although he lived with his mother in his youth, his passion for the piano was inspired by his father. Sondheim's first mentor was Oscar Hammerstein II, the famous lyricist, playwright, and composer. Some of Hammerstein's popular works include The Sound of Music and Oklahoma. Sondheim ended up under the guidance of Hammerstein when he befriended one of Hammerstein's sons, Jimmy. Stephen and Jimmy were such good friends, Sondheim often spent a lot of time in the Hammerstein household. With Sondheim's father out of the picture, Hammerstein took on the role of father figure to Sondheim, and eventually, his mentor. Sondheim first showcased his talent at age 15, writing an original musical entitled By George, chronicling the experience of George school students. Ironically enough, the musical was well received by all except Hammerstein. When Sondheim showed the script to Hammerstein, he pretended it was a stranger's work. His mentor went through his work and stated it was, quote, the worst thing he had ever read. Although Hammerstein critiqued his work heavily, Sondheim stated he learned more in that afternoon than most people learn in a lifetime. Sondheim attended Williams College as a music major. After this, he studied with avant-garde American composer Milton Babbitt in New York. Sondheim credits Babbitt as a source of inspiration throughout his career. Sondheim moved to Hollywood, and his first professional career was as a scriptwriter. Sondheim's big break into musical theater was through his lyrics for the famous West Side Story. After his breakout, Sondheim secured his status as an extremely talented composer and musician with Gypsy, a musical about a stripper. His works are mainly in the musical theater genre, although he has composed scores for films such as Stravinsky and Reds. Sondheim has composed and written over 50 works, including A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Forum, Company, Evening Primrose, and more. He has received both Oscars and Tonys. The following are excerpts from Sweeney Todd and Into the Woods.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, my lady? Do you wake every morning in shame and despair, discovering your beloved's love and regret? Well, ladies and gentlemen, from now on you can wake and at ease. You need never again have a worry or care. I will show you a miracle marvelous rare. Gentlemen, you are about to see something that marks your day. On the top of my head was Pirelli's miracle elixir. That's what did the trick, sir. True, sir, true. Was it quick, sir? Did it in a tick, sir. Just like an elixir. All to do. How about a bottle, mister? Only cost a penny guarantee. Does Pirelli stimulate the growth, sir? You can have my oath, sir. Tis unique. Rather minute, stimulating in it. Soon you'll have to thin it once a week.
I mean, I'm not sure how to do it.
Oh, Pirelli's miracle elixir. Anything will slick, sir. Suits brass coats. Try Pirelli when they see our fixer. You can have your fixer on the go. Wanna buy a bowl of mixers?
Party fix.
You may know what to need with
to get what you want, better see that you keep what you have.
What midnight dawn? There are giants in the sky. There are big, old, terrible giants in the sky. When you weigh up high and you look below at the world you left and the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you weigh up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, when the sky is lit and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you. Exploring things you've never dared, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you rest. And she draws you close to her giant breast. And you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you're made up for it and all, and you know she's big, but you look real small. Someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you miss all the things you've known, and the world you left, and the thing you own. And the fun is done. You steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you creep below, and the world you know begins to grow. The house and your mother at the door. The house and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky.
I chose to share excerpts from these pieces because they are very popular pieces, but they're very different. Sweeney Todd is a retelling of the famous British myth and a very dark musical. The musical chronicles a murderous barber on a quest to exact his revenge as he pairs with a baker who grinds the bodies and puts them into her pies. Unique to the piece is that even in the darkness of the work, Sondheim brings a lighthearted humor to both music and lyrics. The music itself interweaves ominous sounds with lighter ones. The same is true of the lyrics. The next excerpt is from Into the Woods. This musical weaves well-known fairy tales, an original story about a baker and his wife, as they go on their different quests and the consequences their actions have. The music of this piece is still very humorous and does at times have its darker moments. The music and lyrics have a lot of crossover and layering moments. Sondheim's works, musically and lyrically, often have a likability and quality that is easy to relate to them. Sondheim's works bring a realness and depth that many other composers' and lyricists' works do not have. The works of Sondheim draw you in, are extremely enjoyable, yet challenging.